Hey, I'm Newton Faulkner, and welcome to the Studio Zoo. Well, the Studio Zoo, the kind of concept, has been called a live music documentary, which sums it up relatively well, which is from the first guitar take to kind of the last mix, coming back and me listening to it and being like, yes, that is done, has all been committed to webcam. And it's been broadcast live to the internet, and people have been able to watch. And what it became was me literally talking to people from the second I woke up to the second I went to bed. Like, I wake up and I check my phone, there's a bunch of tweets, people asking me to say stuff, and I just say stuff to the cameras and then get on with it. The writing process was very much about pushing my playing, and there's a lot of stuff on this which is really hard. There's loads of really challenging things to do, because that's part of the way my playing style kind of developed, was writing stuff that I can't play and almost purposefully attacking weak areas of my playing. Like, kind of early on, my hammer-ons weren't quite strong enough, so I wrote I Need Something as an exercise to beef up my hand, which is bizarre, but I've kind of done it with this as well. There's certain things that I'm not so good at, so I wasn't good at this kind of pulling off perfectly in time, so I've written something which is all pull-offs, like the whole thing, and it had to be really tight. And then I did the same guitar part on both sides, and it had to be really tight. And then the harmonic tuning thing, which I've only done a little bit of in the past, basically just based a whole track on it, just so I've got that down. And it's a bizarre way of working, but it's good fun. When we were deciding time frames, and we decided we were going to do a 5-week chunk of recording, which isn't very long, so it was going to be intense and fast, and not only were we creating audio, which was obviously the main mission — if we didn't do that, we would have failed miserably — but we also had to keep it entertaining and keep it interesting on a visual level. So one way we've done that is we've had loads of guests come in. We've had some amazing people, loads of amazing vocalists, and had India Bourne came in and plays cello with Ben Howard, and does her own stuff as well. And we've got Ted from Mumford & Sons coming in. I think he's in tomorrow. So it's kind of an endless — we've had loads of amazing people. We had an amazing artist come in, a guy called Joe Simpson. He actually did a portrait of me for an exhibition a while ago. It was just amazing. And he came back and painted a whole wall in a day. It was just two of them came, and they just kind of just blitzed the whole — it was amazing. There's loads of good — and also because of all the cameras, we could do really interesting kind of time-lapse stuff, so you could see it kind of sped up, which was amazing. What else has gone? We've had loads of — and competition winners coming in. Yeah, we had Mike and James come in, and we had a jam, and obviously there's no shortage of guitars here. That's one thing that we don't have a problem with, so that was really fun. I think having the kind of constant fan presence has had just a really positive effect on the record as a whole, and it's made me do things — it's basically made me do things the hard way and actually try and play things right in the first place, as opposed to jumping in and editing and chopping things. And I've tried to get things as right as possible. I think partly the reason for that was because it was definitely more fun to watch.
Cool. Night, guys.